Hi, I'm Kirsty Meekin from Neo Nails. In this series of videos, I'm going to show you how to do some gorgeous bridal designs. Okay, for this design, it's going to be very bridal, so very elegant and a bit gorgeous. So I'm just going to clean over this nail. I've already prepped it, which means I've removed the surface shine. What I'm going to do now is fit a tip. And what I'm going to do with the tip, is just bend it slightly in the middle so I can see that that fits from side to side. So the reason I do that is because this nail has got quite a natural C curve on it. So I want to make the tip even more curved. I want 1 to 2 mil of glue, brush on glue, just on that contact area. And we're using the competition edge tip. Just going to secure those wings down. So we call these tips of this tip. Those are the wings. So we just pinch that tip a little bit more, just so I know that it's got that nice C curve. What I do need to do is cut some length away, and then I'm going to cut at an angle at the side just to take those corners off. That's going to reduce the filing down. So I'm filing this straight, coming slightly in, so it's tapered. So we're going to do a ballerina shape. It's called a ballerina shape because it looks like a ballerina slipper. You know, the blocks that the ballerinas wear. So they've got blocks in the end so they don't hurt the toes, but I'm sure it's still painful. And again, this side. And I'm using the straight side of the file because I'm filing the straight edge. Going to dust that off so I can see what I'm working with. Still making sure we've got this nice C curve that runs to the end. And then we're just going to slightly blend that contact area, avoiding the natural nail. You just want to file over the actual tip to blend that a little bit. You don't have to go too crazy with it, because what we're going to do next is get a lint-free pad, little bit of acetone, pure acetone. Pop that on top and just side to side a few times. Check it. You see how that dissolves that contact area of the tip. And I'm just going to rub that up the sides a little bit, just to dissolve that a little bit more. And where it's dissolved, I'm just making sure that that's still nice and straight at the sides. I'm just whipping over a little bit of the file just to abrase that. Cleaning the natural nail bed with a bit of acetone. Then I'm going to dehydrate with the nail prep dehydrator. Let that naturally dry and evaporate. And then we're going to prime just the natural nail. Now that's all prepped, I'm going to use 3 different powders. So we're going to use Mega White and Intense Pink Shimmer and Clear. Now I'm going to line them up at an angle like this. Because what I don't want to do is, when I pick up a bead, if I just show you. I'll just show you for instance. When I pick up that bead and go to the nail, any powder that drops off is not going to go into that powder or that powder. I'm always going to go from here to here, and I'm never going to contaminate the powders with other colours, if you get me. I'm going to use Max Adhesion and pour it down the brush, which is going to force it straight into that dampened dish. We're going to start at the free edge. So this is a gorgeous ombre, really popular. So starting with the white, I bled the back of the brush out because I don't want it to just start running like crazy. I'm blending that bead up over halfway up the nail. And then what I'm going to do is cut that bit out. And then what I'm going to do is bring the bulk of this product down to the tip of the nail. The skill of getting an ombre looking really beautifully faded and neat is this first layer that you put down. If this first layer is lumpy bumpy, when you put your next colour on top, whether that is a natural beige or a shimmer powder, it still needs to be nice and smooth and flat. If there are lumps here, when you put your next colour on, it will show through, especially when you start to file the nail. So you want to get this as neat as you can. I'm just getting a wet bead now and just blending that a little bit more. So tiny little wet bead just to blend that a little bit further. And then with the intense pink shimmer, you're going to get a bead. Clean my brush. Pat the back. So I placed it close to the cuticle, but I didn't flood it. I'm tipping the finger down, so the product's going to draw down away from the cuticle. And then I'm going to blend the bulk of this product down. We're still building an apex at this time as well, don't forget. So you can see here, we've started to build an apex. I'm going to get one last bead of intense pink because I want it to be more intensified at this apex area. So the more of this product that you put on, the more of this powder that you put on, you can see it will be more intense. You can put it on nice and thin if you want, if you just want a nice thin layer and you don't want it super pink. You can just put it on nice and thin and then cap it in clear. The reason I love this powder is because of its intensity. And it also covers really nice. So I wouldn't necessarily call this a cover pink or a camouflage pink. However, it covers really well. So you can extend with this product as well. And if you want to find this product on the website, all you need to do is look in the description box below this video and you can find all the products that we use in this video. So it's still nice and neat, you can see from the side. What we're going to do now is get clear, nice bead of clear, like a medium size, and we're going to encapsulate all of this work. So you're going directly over the top, and then nice long strokes, lightly on the product, sliding that down the nail and capping everything that we've done. Also, what's that going to do? It's also going to build your apex as well, which is going to sit in the back third. Clean my brush. And then what I'm going to do is allow that to set up a little bit. Obviously, if you were doing a full set, when you come to do the other nails, it'll start to set naturally. But I need to just monitor this nail for the purpose of the video, because I'm going to pinch. See, if I touch this now, see how it sticks to my fingers? Too early, that is. You can also put your fingers into some clear powder. Kind of like baking. And test pinch it. So you don't stick to it, but you can feel if the nail is going to collapse. By that I mean the product's going to go and squish, because you don't want that. You want everything to remain where you've put it. So as I'm pressing and test pinching this with my fingers, I can feel that yes, it's got some bounce, but it's also got some stability as well. So this is the time that we can pinch. So I can put that pinching tool on, let it do its thing, let it start bringing those sides in. So we've got a nice, gorgeous C curve. You can add a tiny bit more pressure if needed. You can also move it up. So if you move it up, you're gonna get some more pressure. So you can see that this looking a lot slimmer now. And we want everything to look really nice and slim. So I'm just continuing to pinch down the length of that nail. So I'm going to check the C-curve here as I'm pinching.